and the next talk is by Sucheta. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
And she's going to talk again about something absolutely new, stem cells and ROP.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you, Professor Azhar, Dr. Anand, and IROP Society for this opportunity. I have tried to make this topic as simple as possible. So stem cells are basically like mother cells who differentiate into different types by three mechanisms. First is they replicate themselves to form more stem cells. They can differentiate to form specialized tissue cells. And in the context of ROP, these could be vascular endothelial cells or neuronal cells. And thirdly, they can have a paracrine effect. Paracrine effect is a chemical way of communication between stem cell and an adjacent host cell, where a stem cell stimulates an adjacent host cell to start replicating without actually taking part in this process of replication. So in the context of ROP, these last two mechanisms are likely to have, you know, potential use in the future. So in early 2000s, scientific community got initial breakthroughs by way of, you know, acquiring retinal progenitor cells, which were identified from mouse retina as well as human fetal retina. And one of the most well-known MIO cell line or Moulfield's cell line was happened when they spontaneously immortalized mural cells from retina. So let me here explain what do we mean by the term spontaneous immortalization. So when a normal cell replicates, on an average 4 to 8 times it divides into more cells and dies its natural death due to aging process after these 8 divisions. Whereas in a spontaneously immortalized cell line, the cells bypass this aging process and then continue to replicate indefinitely. So these spontaneously immortalized cell lines could form a very good source of stem cell therapy for ROP in future. So why should we think of stem cell therapy for ROP? We all know that incidence of ROP has not changed significantly over the past few decades. In fact, the number of severe ROP cases are on the rise in lower and middle income countries. And all the current treatments, those are laser and anti-VEGF treatments, they are more focused on treating advanced stages of ROP. They are not free. They do have adverse effects. And some of the cases, despite the adequate treatment, can have suboptimal outcomes. And none of the present treatments address the underlying pathology of ROP, which is vasocessation or phase one of ROP. And this is where stem cells can prove very useful. They could provide a therapeutic revascularization option of immature retina in preterm infants. So most popular models used in this research are mouse retina models, because retinal vascular developmental stages are well described in mouse models. Mouse models are easy to genetically manipulate, hence they provide as a powerful tool to study pathogenesis of ROP. And stages of vessel development in infant newborn mouse mimic those of human fetus at 16 to 20 weeks of gestational age. So in an ischemic situation, there is damage to pericytes and endothelial cells, as a result of which, you know, vascular occlusion happens. This is the phase one of ROP. So potentially mesenchymal stem cells could form new pericytes and endothelial vascular cells and can result in revascularization of the damaged retinal vessels. So these stem cells not only reduce the avascular and neovascular area, but they also accelerate retinal revascularization. And injection of these stem cells also inhibits inflammatory activity, which is of course a collateral benefit. In the mouse models, it was studied whether these kind of stem cell injections have long-term effect on the structure and function of the retina. And it was observed that there was no abnormal retinal structure or function observed in the injected eyes compared to control eyes at the end of 6 months after injection, which is indeed a good news for, you know, human ROP treatment in future. And one of the most useful mode of administration for stem cells in the context of ROP could be intravitreal injection of stem cells. However, animal models do have their own limitations, animal models cannot fully simulate situation in the human. Human preterm infants usually have other complications after birth, such as, you know, bronchopulmonary dysplasia, septicemia, necrotizing enterocolitis, etc. And these coexisting morbidities are not observed in full-term newborn animals. So we are not sure whether we are really comparing, whether we are really making apple-to-apple comparison here. It has been documented that preterm infants do have circulating stem cell population in their peripheral blood, and perhaps these stem cells could play an important role in development of retinal and development of various organs such as retinal vasculature, but they could also prevent, you know, pathological formation of blood vessels. So in the clinics, we often observe that infants with zone 1 ROP are at high risk of developing severe disease and have poorer prognosis compared to those with zone 2 ROP. Therefore, restoring the retinal vasculature, which is immature, could help in preventing as well as reducing neovascularization. And this could be achieved with the help of stem cells. In the future, a few of the sources of the stem cell therapy for ROP could be as follows. The first and most ideal source would be autologous bone marrow. However, the procedure is very painful and you cannot often carry out such procedure in a sick newborn. The next best option would be allogeneic HLA matched donor, but it is not without the risk of graft rejection. I think the most easily accessible source is maternal umbilical cord blood. But its use in humans to prevent ROP needs further studies, and there are obvious ethical concerns for carrying out studies in preterm children who are often sick. And this is the most important factor in limiting the, you know, rate of speed of research in this field. So to conclude, stem cell therapy could provide preventive as well as therapeutic option for ROP in near future. Who knows, this might become a reality after a few years. But until then, I think ROP experts have to act like stem cells to produce more progenies who are competent enough to treat ROP. Thank you.